On our 3 month trek on up to Maine, we were about halfway into that move and we were headed to Hershey, Pennsylvania, when disaster struck our tow vehicle. It got whacked on the turnpike in Pennsylvania. Details coming up on RV Street.
So it's Monday morning, it's about 9 o'clock, and it's still chilly and windy, and they were predicting a lot more wind to pick up in the afternoon. So we thought we'd get an early start and just head out and get to Hershey. We were in Roaring River
campground
in Somerset, Pennsylvania. We had about 190 miles to get to Hershey, Pennsylvania campground. So off we go.
Yeah, and we always are watching the weather, especially me. The day or two before our move day, we're really watching that weather. And so we needed to get out of there early in the morning and beat this wind, because when you're going through these highways in Pennsylvania with these, I mean, we're basically going over the Appalachian Mountains, and that wind can get pretty wicked in there.
Yeah, it can.
So off we go. Well, we got out of Roaring River Campground about, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 miles down the winding road, got on the turnpike, started heading east to Hershey, Pennsylvania. And all of a sudden, as I'm driving, I mean, we're just going down like normal. We got the GPS on. Joni's got her tablet there. She's looking and up ahead and everything for traffic, whatever.
Yeah, we were about, I don't know, 20 miles into our trip, I guess.
Just got on, yeah. No more than 20 miles. And all of a sudden, I see this big yellow thing in the road, in my lane, the right. It's only two lanes. And there just was not enough time to try to dodge it. I had traffic on my left. And I'm like, oh boy. And we both thought it was a piece of plywood.
Yeah, initially when it was a little bit further away from us, it kind of looked like a ginormous piece of plywood in the middle of the road.
Ginormous meaning like 3 feet by 4 feet. I mean, it was a big square piece we thought was plywood. No time to react, no time to swerve. So I just guided that motorhome and straddled it. And it went under the motorhome fine. Yeah. We're both looking. I'm looking in my mirrors. I want to see it in my rearview mirror. And I don't see it. And I said, Joni, do you see that yellow thing behind
you?
I
was like, no, I didn't see anything. But then we started feeling this like vibration
in the left front tire. Yeah, we felt this
noise.
Yeah.
This noise in the motorhome and this vibration, and it just kept getting stronger. And we're like, what the heck is that? So Martin found a place to pull over.
I'm like, you know what? We need to pull over. Something's not right.
Yeah, definitely not right.
So we pulled over. I walked out and went down the side to the back of the car. And I see that big, it was a metal door. It looked like an access door off of a
tractor trailer, maybe.
Or a Caterpillar backhoe. Or
something.
Yeah, it was huge. It had went under the toad and bounced up underneath the rear axle and wedged itself underneath there between the axle and the gas tank. Yeah. And we were dragging it. I immediately saw that and I was like, oh my God, I need to get that out of there. I wish I would have taken more video and pictures of all this. I got some here that we're going to show you.
We were kind of more in panic mode, maybe. You can
here
see
we are on
the
side of the freeway, you know. But anyway, so I get up underneath the car and I'm bending and turning this big gigantic metal plate, and I finally yanked it out, and there's oil all over that plate. I drug it over on the side of the road and I walked up. Now Joni's out there with me. And I walked up to the front of the car and got on my hands and knees and looked up under the car. And here I see a hole in the engine about this big.
Martin goes, "Oh my God, Joni, look." And I did. And I was like, "Oh my God."
Well, we ran over a piece of metal that was laying in the road on our way to Harrisburg. It cleared the motorhome, but it came and hit the car and ripped right through the engine and lodged in the back. And I just pulled it out and put it here. I was so devastated and mad at myself because I did not, I you know, it's always this high insight 2020, you know, gosh, I could have swerved it. No, I couldn't. Well, I could have done better. I should have this, I should have that, I should have, because I'm always such a very defensive driver. I'm always looking way ahead and watching people coming alongside of us and all that, and somehow.
But the reality of it is, really, and you know, he's kind of hard on himself, the reality of it is there was nowhere to go and you couldn't get stopped in time.
Right.
So yeah. He did the best that he could do, and this is what happened, so.
Our very first
incident.
This was, if you look at that, our opening video right up over here, the first one we made almost a year ago, exactly. We were in Florida. It was our virgin video.
Yeah.
And Joni says, and I'm sure we'll have some bumps and bruises.
Well, this is our first bump.
This was our first big bump.
And bruise.
So I immediately said, Joni, we need to get a hold of the insurance company and we need to get a tow. Now, bear in mind, we're towing this behind the motorhome. And I was afraid to continue towing it because there was oil everywhere under that car. And I was afraid that if we continued to tow it, as you know, heat might build up in the brake calipers or the axles or something, start a fire, and now we're dragging a fire behind us. So I thought we probably need a tow. She's on the phone with the insurance company. I'm on the phone with the tow company. We have CoachNet. And then all of a sudden, a truck pulls up. It was a dump truck. And he checks to see if we're okay. And he immediately tells us, yeah, there's only one tow company on this turnpike that's allowed to tow. And it's XYZ company. I don't remember who they
are. And it's going to cost us about $200.
Or more.
Or more.
They start at $200.
Yeah.
And I thought, well, we've got CoachNet. And so anyway, Now I got on the phone with them. He gave me their phone number and all that kind of stuff. So I'm on the phone talking to him, to these people. Then another truck pulls up. And this truck was called the Pennsylvania Turnpike Safety Patrol.
Tollway Safety Patrol.
Yeah.
Yeah, something like that.
And it's all over his car, all over his truck. He's got the red lights and everything on top. And he asks us, what's going on? I ran everything down to him. He says, let me take a look at that. And he gets underneath there and he goes, whoa, man. he says, you hit that. He points to the metal plate. He goes, you hit that? That was on the freeway? And I said, yep. He said, well, you can tow that. Because we found a Ford dealership 4 miles down.
Yeah.
It was only 4 miles away.
It was TriStar Ford. It was 4 miles away from where we're sitting on the turnpike. He said, I'll tell you what. He said, you guys drive to the toll and get off the toll road. He said, and then I'll get out in front of you and I'll lead you to the Ford dealership.
Yeah, yeah. He said, let's both get on the freeway, and he was going to jump ahead and he was going to lead us there. And he did. We went in to TriStar. The guy said, yeah, can I help you? I said, yep. I says, we have an emergency here. Our car got whacked. We need, the engine's got a hole in it this size in it.
So he said, is your name Jordan? And Martin said, yes. And he goes, oh, your insurance company has already contacted us.
Yeah. This happened at 9:30 in the morning. We're on the side of the freeway doing all these calls. We get to the dealer like 10:15, 10:30, insurance company has already called them.
So yep. we do all the paperwork, and we go and we clean out the car of the things that we're going to need until the car is ready, and things we just don't want to leave in there. And off to Hershey, Pennsylvania we go.
Yeah, we're like, there's nothing we can do. They're going to have this car for a while.
Yeah, and we had the reservations in Hershey, and, you know, this is just the way it is. So. Yeah.
So we got back in the motorhome, got back on the turnpike, devastated. Now I'm really nervous. Man, I'm looking at every little hole. But that was a long 160 miles or so. But we figured we'd just go there, park, get settled in. When our car's done, we'll rent a car, come back and get it. So I'll let you finish the second part of this.
Okay.
So we drive to Hershey and we exit off the turnpike. It's now almost 5 o'clock in the afternoon, because we didn't even leave TriStar Ford till about 12:15, 12:30. We finally exit. We're headed off now to the campground. I told Joni, I said, and this is kind of one of our habits, I said, let's go ahead and top off on fuel while we're right here.
Yeah.
And then we'll go park. And sure enough, boy, there was a great place to pull in. I pulled in at top, and as soon as I pulled in, I put it in park, I turned off the engine, and the phone rang.
Yeah, so I answered the phone, and the guy is, you know, asking me some questions, and he's telling me that he has already found an engine for our car, and this, you know, they're looking at turnaround time of about 4, possibly 5 days. We're like, oh, thank goodness, you know, just like, we have reservations all over the place, and this could be very bad. But he did say, well, he said, initially we thought we were going to have to total the car. And I'm like, oh my God, no, you can't do that. We don't want you to total the car.
Yeah, the car's paid for. And you know what they do when they total it. You know, they give you the very lowest bottom price it's worth. And then you got to come up with thousands of dollars extra to go get another
but
car.
It wasn't even that. It was, you know, the tow package that we already put on the car.
Yeah.
And we didn't want to have to jump through all of those hoops. And
yeah. I mean, I spent a lot of time when we were in Houston before we went off on this journey. I mean, I spent a ton of hours researching, equipping, buying, installing all the equipment. It was about $3,000 to trick out the car, the motorhome, the tow package, the chains, the lights, the emergency cable, all that crap. And they're going to total. I was like, oh God, no.
So anyway, you know, I get off the phone with the insurance dude, and I'm telling Martin what's going on. And I looked at Martin and I said, do you suppose he realizes that that is a manual transmission? And I said, well, of course he does. He's got all the paperwork, and this is his job. And off we went to Hershey.
They proceed getting this new engine. They didn't want to try to just rework the bottom half of the crankcase. They said, no, we're just going to do the whole thing. So they found the insurance companies, they have to restore you to where you were or better. So they bought, they found a 2019 engine in a car that was rear-ended. The car was total, but the engine was fine. So they went and got that engine. Took 2 days to get that to the dealer. That's Friday. Now we wait through the weekend. They come back to work on Monday. And the dealer calls me and says, we got a little problem here. I said, what's the problem? He says, well, the engine is came out of an automatic, and yours is a stick, and there's going to be some other hoops we have to jump through. And
parts we have to order. And about that time, I was really kicking myself in the butt for not saying something to begin with.
Yeah. The bottom line to all this, without going into all the details, is it didn't take 4 days turnaround. It took 2.5 weeks turnaround to get the car to where TriStar called and said, Mr. Jordan, it's ready to go. It's ready to go. It's been tested. It's been cleaned. Everything's good to go. So we had rented another car, because we rented one for 4 days. We turned it in. We're like, man, this is going to take forever. No sense in racking up all this money.
Yeah.
So now we had to go through that process again, drive 160 miles back.
170
back to Somerset, Pennsylvania, where the car was. Drop off the rent car, go pick up the regular, our car, get back on the turnpike, come back another 170 miles or whatever it was. It was a whole day event.
Yeah, I mean, all in all, the way this all worked out, I mean, there was a stop that I wanted to make. It was very important to me in Accord, New York. We had to cancel that because we had to stay for an extra week in Hershey. The park was amazing with us to, you know, work and finagle all of the reservations for us.
We actually did a review on that park since we didn't have a car. We stayed in the park a lot, but you can see that review right up there on the Pennsylvania Thousand Trails Park. But yeah, it really messed with our plans because we had something important we wanted to do in New York. We had to kill that. We're going to catch that when we come, when we leave Maine and start heading back down following the colors. So yeah, it all turned out.
I mean, it all turned out fine. You know, we have our car back. They didn't total it. It was a, you know, kind of a freaky situation initially, but we got through it. All is good.
All is good. And I'm really, really going to be keeping my eyes even further down the road now. I mean, it's amazing how something like that will really perk up your antennas. You think you're a real defensive driver until all of a sudden something's thrown right in front of you and it's like, and you don't just swerve with a motorhome, you know.
Yeah.
So anyway, there you have it. Our first
bump and bruise.
Our bump and bruise almost exactly 1 year after we started this adventure. It was devastating at the time. Oh, I can't tell you how shook up I was. But all is well now. Oh, by the way, please subscribe or consider subscribing to our channel and liking this video. We would really like the support and your comments.
Absolutely.
This is RV Street. Stick around.